Hello dear students, in today's video we are going to solve two numericals of the chapter force and laws of motion, right? So first we'll discuss numerical, that is question number 14 of NCERT exercise of your textbook. So what is that? Let us read out. A bullet of mass 10 gram traveling horizontally with velocity of 150 meters per second strikes a stationary wooden block and comes to rest in 0.03 seconds. Calculate the distance of penetration of the bullet into the block. Also calculate the magnitude of force exerted by a wooden block on the bullet. So basically what this question is all about, a bullet is traveling, right, and it penetrates a wooden block, children. And the question is, when it penetrates the wooden block, how much distance does it travel before coming to rest? How much is the distance traveled by the bullet in the wooden block, and what is the magnitude of force exerted by the wooden block on the bullet? So force and distance, how much distance the bullet has traveled in that, penetrated in that wooden block, that you have to find out. So just see that what we are given. First we'll write what we are given and what we need to find out. So in this case, if I say what is the mass of the bullet, so mass of the bullet is 10 gram. You know that you have to convert it into SI unit. So 10 gram means 10 upon 1000 kgs, or that will be 10 to the power of minus 2 kgs. Right? So we have converted into SI unit. Next, this wooden block and comes to rest in 0.03 seconds. Now children, just imagine what is happening here. A bullet is moving with a speed of 150 meter per second, correct? So when it enters the wooden block, what is its initial speed? Its initial speed will be 150 meter per second. So u is given as 150 meter per second. So what is happening? What is the value of V? After some time, after 0.03 seconds, it comes to rest. So after traveling a certain distance, which we do not know, that it comes to rest. So V is what? V is zero. So final velocity of the bullet is zero. Next, what is the time in which it comes to rest? It is given as time is 0.03 seconds. It is given to us. Now what we need to calculate is distance. We need to calculate distance. Now we have three equations of motion. V is equal to u plus at, s is equal to ut plus half at square, and the last one, v square minus u square is equal to 2as. We have to choose the suitable equation. Children, we need to find the value of s, right? So for that, I need to find at least what is the acceleration of the bullet. For that, what I can do? I can use the first equation of motion. So using equation V is equal to u plus at. From this, I can write acceleration is nothing but V minus u upon t. V minus u upon t. Now, what is the value of V? We know that it comes to rest. So 0 minus u. What is u? 150 upon 0.03. Time kitna hai? 0.03. So this is a mathematical calculation that we can do. So 0 minus 150 upon 0.03. This we have substituted. Now next step, we'll calculate minus 150 divided by 0.03. So 0.03 can be written as 3 multiplied by how many decimal places? 1, 2. So 10 to the power of minus 2. So next step, what I can do, I can cancel this. So this will become 3 5s are 15. So 50 into, and this minus 2, when it will go up, this will become positive. So 50 into 10 to the power of plus 2. This is not the scientific way to write. So I will write acceleration as, and negative sign is also there. So minus of 5 into 10 to the power of 3 meter per second. So this is the acceleration of the bullet. It means velocity is decreasing with time. Now, do we need to find just acceleration? No. What has been asked in the question? Distance. So distance, I will use the formula using equation v square minus u square is equal to 2as. This s I need to find out. Now we'll substitute. What is the value of v? V is 0. V is 0. So 0 minus u square. U is how much? U is given as 150. So 150 multiplied by 150. 150 square is what? 150 into 150 is equal to 2 into acceleration. What is the acceleration we have found out? Acceleration is minus 5 into 10 to the power of 3 into S. S hume nikala. That S has to be found out. So which implies, what will be the value of S? All of you can calculate it. So I'll just write it down. Minus 150 into 150 whole divided by, this thing will come down. So this will be minus 2 into 5. How much it is? 10 into 10 to the power of 3. 10 into 10 to the power of 3. Now what is, we can cut one zero, okay? So 15 into 15 is 225. 10 is left, 0 into this 10 is to the power of 3, it will go up. So this will become 10 to the power of minus 3. That will give you 2.25. What is this? It is in meters. So this is S, distance traveled will be 2.25 meters. Now one more thing we need to calculate. Calculate the magnitude of force. So what it will be? Do you know the formula? Yes, formula for force is given as force equals mass into acceleration. What is the mass of the bullet? It is 10 to the power of minus 2. And what is the acceleration? Acceleration is minus 5 into 10 to the power of 3. So what it will be? It will be simply 10 to the power of minus 2 and 3 here. So this will be simply 50, that too of negative, minus 50 newton. But what has been asked in the question? It is asked only the magnitude of force. So magnitude, when we are talking about, we need to write, therefore magnitude of force will be, magnitude of force will be equal to just 50 newton. So this is the final answer. Now children, let us start with the question number 15 of NCERT, right? So first we will discuss the problem. What exactly the problem is, what we have to solve for. An object of mass 1 kg traveling in a straight line with a velocity of 10 meter per second. So mass is 1 kg, mass is 1 kg and velocity is 10 meter per second. Collides with and stick to, it collides and stick to a stationary wooden block of mass 5 kg. Then they both move off together in the same straight line. Then you have to calculate the momentum. Calculate the momentum just before the impact, just before the impact and just after the impact. Also calculate the velocity of the combined object. So three things you have to calculate. The momentum before the impact, just before the impact, momentum just after the impact, and what is the velocity of the combined. So what exactly the problem is? An object of mass 1 kg, an object of mass 1 kg is moving with a velocity of 10 meter per second. This is moving with a velocity of 10 meter per second, right? It collides with a stationary wooden block. It collides with a stationary wooden block of mass 5 kg. Now this block is stationary, means its velocity is 0. Its velocity is 0. After that, what happens? They sticks. It is written, no, with this, with it, and stick to the stationary wooden block. So what happens when it collides? It gets sticks. Then after that, they move together. This is the object of mass 1 kg and this is the block of mass 5 kg. And they, when they are moving, what is their combined velocity? We need to find out. I hope the question is clear. Once again, a body of mass 1 kg is moving with initial, it's moving with a velocity 10 meter per second. It collides with a wooden block of mass 5 kg, which is at rest. Then both of them, after the collision, they move along the same straight line and now they are the combined object. So what is the velocity of this combination? We need to find out. So here we are going to use the law of conservation of momentum, because there is no external force acting on this. So we shall start with, what is the mass? We take it as first body. Mass of the first body, m1, is given as 1. And what is the velocity? It is given as 10 meter per second, right? Similarly, what is m2? m2 is 5 kg and initial velocity u2 is 0, right? So what is the first thing? Calculate the momentum just before the impact, means before, what we write is momentum before collision. So just before the impact, before impact, what we can write the momentum? Momentum will be some moment. What we can do is momentum will be before, I am denoting by P1, momentum before impact. Okay, I can just write it as P1, momentum before impact. P1 can be written as M1 U1 plus M2 U2. So what is M1? M1 is 1, M1 is 1. U1 is 10, 1 into 10 plus M2 is 5 and U2 is 0. So how much it is? 10. So what will be the units for momentum? It will be kg meter per second. So momentum before impact, just before impact, is 10 kg meter per second. So one part we have calculated. So next, what is the momentum just after the impact? So after impact, we know the law of conservation of momentum, right? To conserve momentum and there is no external force acting on it. So momentum before collision should be equal to momentum after collision. So after collision, if I write it as P2, so P2 should be equal to P1 and that should is given by 10 kg meter per second only. So the momentum after impact will be equal to momentum before impact. Why? Because of law of conservation of momentum. Momentum before collision should be equal to momentum after collision, and that is given by 10 kg meter per second. So we have calculated the second part also, just after the impact. Now what is the third thing? Also calculate the velocity of the combined object. Children, from law of conservation of momentum, I can write, from law of conservation of momentum, I can write down that what we have learned, that M1 U1 plus M2 U2 is equal to, now this was the initial before collision. So what is happening after that? These two bodies are getting combined. So M1 plus M2, and they are moving with one common velocity. Of course, when they are combined, they will move with one velocity only. So what is this value? This, from where I have written, law of conservation of momentum. So this value already we have calculated. This is 10, right? Is equal to M1. What is M1? 1. What is M2? 5. And what is the velocity we need to calculate? So velocity, combined velocity V, will be given by 10 by 6. And that will come out to be something about 1.67 meters per second.